Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be going over some advanced exercises to help you improve your SketchUp skills. All right, so here is our first object. Your tip for this is solid tools. In this, I'm going to start with a square. So I'm going to hit R to make the rectangle tool, type 2 foot by 2 foot, and then push pull this up 2 feet. Make this a group. I'm going to draw a line from the corner here to that corner. Select in there. I know that I'm selecting somewhere in there because I just selected everything and then I deselected the box. I'm just going to make a circle here. We'll make the radius 1.25 feet. And then just adding another circle here. That'll be our path. Select follow me for the shape. Put this into that box. So I'm just gonna make a copy, put it over there, group it. Now it should say solid group, and this should also say solid group. I'm gonna select both of them. And then in my solid tools, I'm going to select intersect. You can see I get something similar. Obviously I can mess with the sizes. This sphere may need to be bigger if I want something more similar to what's over here. So if I do that using the scale tool, then intersect, I get something much more similar to what is over there. Here is your second shape. Your tip for this one is follow me. This one can actually be pretty tricky. And actually I did a tutorial specifically on how to make this. So I'm gonna rush through it here, but feel free to search through our library on YouTube to find out how to make a spring. So I'm just gonna start by making a circle. Make sure you note how many sides there are. So there are 24 in this, that's standard in SketchUp. So I'm just gonna make a circle there. It doesn't really matter too much about what it looks like. And then I'm gonna copy this up. This also doesn't matter that much for the way that I'm gonna do this. And then I'm gonna draw a line here from here over to the next little segment or the end of that segment. I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna find the center. I'm gonna copy it to here and then times 23. Because I have 24 sides, so I already had one, so it's gonna give me 24 total lines. I'm gonna erase all those, and then same thing, I'm gonna go up. Because those are segments, it's gonna be able to start to make this sort of helix shape times 23, so I can get a full rotation. So I'll just select all of it, hit Control X to get rid of it, zoom out, you can see there's a ton going on. I'm just gonna take that and then paste it back in because I had cut it to my clipboard. I'm gonna scale it down. So we have this guy. Now, what I've tried to do in the past with this is get it so that the shape sort of goes up and that this would be one sort of component. When you do that, because of the orientation of the first and the last part of the shape, it usually doesn't work. So I found that the best way to do a sort of continuous helix is to just continue the line work. So we're gonna go, let's say up 3 or 4, and then squish this again. I'm gonna draw my circle here, go on the right. You just wanna sort of make sure that this is generally perpendicular with this line. So you could always make that line go in an axis and then draw your circle. It'll make your shape just look more round as it goes up instead of squashed. And then what I'm gonna do is select all these lines, select follow me, select my shape, and you get this guy and it has some segments. Then what you need to do is soften. Just come down here and you just mess with the slider until you get what you're looking for. Here is your third shape. Your tip for this is dynamic component. And just before we get into this, I just want to say that the dynamic components in this are pro-only features. You can only create them if you have SketchUp Pro. So as you click on this, it should be able to change colors. So the first thing that we're going to do here is start by making a circle, or a sphere, I guess. So we're going to start with a circle, and then go this way, follow me along that, just scale that up a little bit. So now we have our circle here. So what we want to do is go to component attributes. You can also do that under window, I believe. And we just need to make this a component. So make it a group, and then make it a component. And now what we need to do, or at least what I like to do, is add the material just so I can visually see what the material is. Right now it doesn't have anything because the material is not, there's no material applied, it's just the default material. So I'm going to get rid of some of these windows, open my materials, and you can see these are the default colors. If I get off of this and then go back in, you'll see it has updated to color F03. For this, I'm just going to do yellow, red, and blue. So I think if I type in blue, it might even change to that color. Yeah. So it chooses like a specific color in here. So what I want to do is that when I click on it, it does that. So you need to add an attribute called onClick, and then you change this to set, and then you need to put in parentheses your command, and then your three different colors. So blue, red, yellow, parentheses, enter. And if you see just under functions, if you can see all your commands in here, and under somewhere there should be set. Onclick functions, this just gives you sort of an overview of attribute would be what you want to change, and then the states are the three colors that I chose. So now when I click on this, let me just hit enter on this. Make sure it sort of saved that. When I click on it, it will cycle through. You can see if I have this up, it will say what the material is as I go through. Here is your fourth model. Your tip for this is divide. In a previous video, I made a bunch of these, and I actually realized the technique that I used to make the cactus is actually really helpful in doing sort of organic shapes. So we'll start really quickly. I'm going to press C here to make the pot. So just do something like that. Press P to push pull up. We'll go to about there. Then we're going to scale this out. Hold Control to make it a uniform scale out. Use the offset tool. Just go out a little bit. Select that outer ring, press P to push pull up, go to about there, and then we'll take this top piece and we'll just pull that right up so we have a little rim inside and some area for dirt. So there is our pot. I'm not going to add any colors to this, feel free to do that, but I'm not going to. And then what I'm going to do in the middle here is draw on face, so we have a group there, just draw on face here, push pull this up to about here, take this face, select it, and then copy that down to the beginning. Now I'm gonna hit divide, and you can choose any number for this. So what I did is I moved that using control down, and now I'm going to divide to segment this cylinder that I just made. So if you choose 10, so we have these 10 little segments. So now you can select essentially each ring, and you can scale the transform a little bit to get some shapes that you're looking for. And then typically the one, like, I like when stuff sort of rounds in. So with this top one, I make it very tiny, like as tiny as I can get. And you could always do an arch, but I feel like this, you know, does a good enough job. You get something like this, and then you just have to sort of move these lines vertically as well. So if we do something like this, bring this guy up and out just to get some more, just go a little subtle with our cactus. So maybe it bows out that way, and then just getting some, an organic feel here. And then, as always, you know, feel free to move things up and down so it feels less, or it feels more organic. And the more divisions you make, the smoother it will feel. And maybe even if it's not right, just bring it up again and do the same thing you did for that last segment. Let's say divide by three. So make this guy as tiny as you can make it. The top usually needs a little bit more work if you want it to look good. So you have this, and if I just make this a group and then smooth it, sometimes that doesn't work, so you can always just copy these, or actually let's press the eraser tool. We'll just go straight down. So E, control, and then I just dragged over those. And maybe this bottom one, we want to be a little bit smaller. Let's turn on hidden geometry here. And then what I did for this guy is I just made a copy, scaled it down, and then just sort of rotated it to get my arm. And you could always union those together. It may be, because of the way that we did it, there's going to be circles in there you're going to have to get rid of, but primarily that is the shape. For your last and final challenge, this is probably the hardest, and I know it looks really, really simple, but it, actually if you click on it and press S to scale, you can see that when I drag this up and then let go, that it keeps the width of the line and just adds more lines as needed. So you can actually shrink and it'll do the same thing, and then you can change the width as you need as well. So your tip for this one is dynamic component. And just a reminder, any dynamic components, unfortunately, you can't do in anything other than SketchUp Pro. So if you don't have SketchUp Pro, unfortunately, you won't be able to do this one. Okay, so what I'm gonna start with here is by making a rectangle. So I'm just gonna do 8 foot by 2 feet. Just reverse this face for my own sanity. Right click, make it a group. I'm just gonna copy this up a little bit. Make it another group, and then make that group a component. I'll call this crosswalk 2, since we already have another one over here. And then I'm going to just delete that other group. Essentially, just for my own, the way that I like to do things is if I go into component attributes, you can see I have crosswalk 2, and then within that I have a group. Before I deleted that last group, I had 2 in there. I only need 1, but just this helps me set up and think about the hierarchy of the group as I'm making it. So that's why I did it that way. And then for crosswalk 2, which is like the overall arching, the overarching group, we want to set up some parameters. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring in len y, and then we also want to just hide some of the scale tools so that we don't mess anything up. We just want it to scale in the x and y direction, so we're just going to turn off all the scale nodes, I guess you might call them, so that no one can scale this in the wrong way, or the way that we don't intend it. Now for line, I'm gonna bring in the Y position. And I'm also going to bring in the length. And I'm just going to set this, I'm going to set equal to 24 inches. And that's just going to say like, hey, this is always going to be 24 inches. You can make that a parameter if you want. For this, I'm not going to do that. And then I also need to bring in copies. This is essentially the math that we're going to use to say how many multiples we're going to have. So for copies, we're just going to throw in an equation here. I'm going to hit equals and then click on the overall. This is the that larger number of the overall group divided by the size of our stripe here. Partially the issue with this, so it says 1 here. You can see it says 8, but it didn't make copies because we're not there yet. And then the other thing I want to add in is spacing. I'm just going to add in a custom parameter here. There we go. And then what we need to do is set our copies here. So in position, we're going to set this equal to, I think it's copy, times, and then this is going to be our distance. So it's going to be this len x here plus our spacing. Okay. Now this doesn't have anything set to out. So let's just do 6 inches. And you can see that we get this guy. Now when we scale this, we get our line spaced. So we should have, if I take a tape measure, this should be 6 inches and this should be 24. Hopefully you guys thought that this video was helpful. If you did, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. It really helps us grow our channel and allow me to continue making content for you guys. And if you like this, there's beginner and intermediate exercises that you can try too, or if this was maybe too hard and you want to work your way up to this, feel free to check those out as well. I'll link those in the description. But other than that, as always, happy hacking.